And then on, and that was the harassment case with the phone call.
Oh, when I called for information and was told not to call again, it did not, right?
Well, this was the one where the chief of police says that you called his house and scared his wife or something.
No, it's all on record. I said, I'm recording this call from my records. I can play the tape for you. He said, you have the wrong number. And the second time, he said, don't call back. So I didn't.
Well, in any event, you got a new case, and that's why they terminated the program. Okay.
I do have a sworn affidavit from the witnesses.
Hold on. Let me finish. No, I'm not done.
Okay, it says the police reports your lies, and the judge won't take it or look at it.
So this SDP, the supervised diversionary program application that was filed on 12/14/17 was never acted on. And then on 4/3/17, there was a alleged failure to appear. What that did was return the case to the regular docket. That's why it didn't. That's why it was sealed when you made the application.
It was sealed for months
but
after.
But then unsealed after the case was brought back to court.
Only months after. Months after that alleged failure to appear.
Well, there was a second failure to appear allegedly on 3/15/18.
No, I have the record. That's just not true. But the record shows.
Be that as it may.
All right, this is a sworn affidavit from witnesses. I'll ask you to keep the original copy. It's been docketized. It shows the police impersonated doctors, in this case, members of my family. And the judge might want to see it and fire the right cops.
Well, the judge has absolutely no power to fire any cops.
Well, those are officers of her court.
No, they're not. They work for the city of New London. They do not work for the judicial
branch. They report to the judge.
Doesn't have any supervisory.
Okay, well, it's at least enough to dismiss charges. This is sworn. This is the next one here.
You know what I need from you?
What's that?
I need a document.
Give it back? Hold on. No, they didn't. This is the adverse employment actions that have been taken against me as a result of the pending charges. This shows that I can't get work just with the pending charges.
All right.
But this says their police reports are lies, and it's true. So, I don't know why we have to stay in court and deal with lies.
Okay. What is that?
These are just extraneous. I have all of the database records from the court. You know how the court has a non-Google, non-searchable database that you can only sort of go in and request specific people? Well, I've been doing that every month, and they have been adding failure to appear charges. In between today's date and two court dates ago, they added two failure to appear charges, which is one way to pressure people into taking a plea, but it's not legal.
I want all the records for the last 3 years from all of your treatment providers.
Well, the court has everything, including this guy.
Well, I don't have it.
Why should I have to play sick to have my rights?
Because that's the nature of the supervised diversionary.
That you give up the truth.
Up your right to privacy in order to get. Copies of all the clinical notes. What I need is letters showing that you were in treatment from X period to the present day and from X period to X period.
Exactly, and I've been complying with the diversionary program. So I'll bring you that on what's
the
18th?
Get me that on the 18th, okay?
And how soon can we get out of here? I have the whole life.
I can get this call. Do you need me to make a copy of this?
I'd like you to offer this to the judge. I'd like you to tell the judge that a sworn affidavit from witnesses denying police reports accuracy.
All right, but that's what a trial is for.
No, we can leave that pre-trial. That's my instruction to you. If you don't want to follow it, you don't have to.
All right, well, let me think about it.